你好。
Levi wants to play Riven Jungler.
Riven, okay.
Holy shit, that's hype.
And again, Smith seems to be struggling. Oh, he's actually going all in for it. Levi was like, oh,
Smith! No!
Smith got down with Smith! Trippy, okay, Smith's gonna pin him to death instead.
I'm coming!
Kill!
Oh! Shackles!
Yeah. Nice up!
Mad Rife!
God lie.
Mithy is around his mid tower. So it's Mad Life though.
Oh, whoa! Gets himself hooked by the god himself. Should be able to make this hop. No, actually he's got support Mad Life, and Ultimate's gonna look to clean it up. Mithy goes to his own. Clean up the rest of the kills. Mad Life again. Huge hook there. Smith dives into the fountain. That's a quadra kill for Double Lift. Knock down the turrets and take the Nexus and win this execution game. What a wonderful performance.
Welcome back to Palo San Jordi. Daniel C. Pedraco's here, joined by Aiden Zyren Moon and Isaac Azale Cummings Bentley. Now, gentlemen, the stakes may be a little bit lower now, but that just means the mayhem is that much more impactful. We saw it in the last game. Are you ready for some crazy picks?
Oh, I'm ready. I think the stakes are even higher because now there's no excuses. You got to bring out the fun picks and you got to perform on them. And I mean, Double Lift with the premonition there, the ribbon was hype.
And yeah. Reckless said Callista, where I mean, players are telling us they're going to bring out the, you know, the secret sauce, the special picks.
Yeah, and I was actually seeing Bjergsen walking to the stage, he's talking to his player manager. He's like, I want to play something fun.
And bring out the Zed.
Something fun? Hey.
Zed's pretty fun. Well, before we get into the game, let's take a chance to run through those lineups, beginning on the blue side with Team Fire. In the top lane, it's going to be QTV in the jungle, Bangi mid lane, Bjergsen, AD carry, Prey, and support Aphrodite.
And then the opposing team is going to be Team Ice, like always. In the top lane, though, it's going to be Mouse. In the jungle, it's going to be Karsa. Mid lane, Maple, AD carry, Reckless, and support Mata.
And this should be a really good one. I know we already heard Reckless talking earlier on the desk about how he was very excited to play with Mata, and I think he's hoping Mata at least plays somewhat serious, you know, maybe not double jungling.
Well,
he probably would like to have a support in his lane.
I mean, we take a chance to look back at some of his performance. Mata has had some pretty great moments. 1v1, Kosovo, we talked about it.
Mata is clearly the All-Stars MVP.
Well, Mata also is the guy who's talking about when he is, what is it, 2014, Season 4 Worlds. It's like, what's the best support? Gnar. He's like, Gnar support? Really? Like, super troll. The guy played Jace in a competitive match on support. Like, he is not afraid to bring out these things and just have fun.
Look, man, I think that's what it's all about. I personally would love to see Gnar support. That sounds like a terrible idea, but I love terrible ideas as a, you know.
Yeah, just like this cast. Oh <my God.
laughs> Look, man, we're technically Trio NA if we look at Origin, so it was a little bit crazy. But something even more insane, Maple. A player who picked up the Katarina, went off on it, not quite enough to carry a game, but you got to think, if there's a chance to bust it out, this is it.
And I actually think, like, overall, when you're taking Summoner's Rift games, fun modes, everything combined, Maple has been the most impressive player at the tournament for me as far as performance. He smashed on Katarina, he smashed on LeBlanc, he was doing incredible in the 1v1s. This guy's the total package.
And that's what I really love about this event is somebody like Maple, he hasn't been here before, right? Overshine by Westdoor in the past, Toys as well from the same region back in the day. And now it's like, now you get to see Maple on stage. And I feel like myself, I've grown like a greater understanding of Maple's abilities, him as a person. And that's what I love about All-Stars is now you get to know the players a little bit more when they come out of their shell.
Exactly. That's so much of what the event is for, right? Creating the connections between fans and the players. And it's the same way here. Like, Levi is not someone that I really got to see a lot of in the past, and seeing him perform on all these different champions, Levi, I don't even know. We've heard so many different ways
name.
Now. He's wanted to change it throughout the tournament,
exactly.
I guess.
Exactly. His name has changed since he got here.
Yeah.
So it's like Levi when he got here, yep. Then he heard people say it, and he's like, oh, Levi sounds
Levi
better.
Levi sounds good.
Yeah.
Good genes, too,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah. There you go, high quality.
Sell out. Okay. So, I mean, additionally, when I got to watch this guy in IWCA, I mean, you fall in love with a man when you see him EQ his Kha'Zix four times repeatedly to grab four different kills. I don't know if he's going to get the chance to do it here, but we are now into picks and bans. And I'm curious to see what's going to come out. Do you think we're still going to see super serious bans here, or are we just going to see some people spell out some fun three-letter words?
I really don't think so. We shouldn't be seeing serious bans, and Garen should be a sign of things to come. I mean, the players, you can just look at the cams. In the earlier games, players were looking very focused, very serious in champ selecting, and people seem to be having a bit more fun with it, so I think they are going to be going a little bit more loosey-goosey.
Why would you do that? Why would you ban the Alawi out?
Well, they are serious picks and bans. You know, this is the Faker X Peke matchup.
Oh, Triple G coming
classic,
out there.
Yeah, the classic Faker bans, of course, first three champions from Korean client. Just wants to ban him out, give Faker the quick shout-out. Elise coming in the end to spell out ICE. You know, a little brag, a little bravado there, reminding people who came out on top before they get into this game.
They also did actually manage to ban out some champions that are pretty good.
Yeah,
there too. Like,
yeah.
So it's like, ooh, we're going to ban ICE, but we're going to pick the best champions there.
All right, here. Bengi. I guess he's still auditioning, right? Going to go with one of his best champions, the Lee Sin.
You know, we're waiting for some exciting picks. Now, Lee Sin may not be the most unique pick, but always the potential for hype playmaking ability. Can do some crazy things. The insect kicks, I'm sure we can expect from Bengi. But yeah, they're teasing us right now.
And I mean, Ivern is something that I would love to see. We still haven't seen the Ivern come out yet, and it's a champion that's really strong. It's not just like some troll pick. This champion is ridiculously good, especially, I think, when paired with tanks.
Yeah, but it's not that much fun for the player to play a lot of the times. It's a different type of personality that loves to enjoy Ivern. So yeah, it is going to be the Kha'Zix that comes through here for Karsa, trying to be a little bit more aggressive on it. And I love that the Katarina's already locked in too. Two assassins already for Team Ice, ready to go.
Now I've heard a
lot.
There it is. It's the Ivern game. We've been waiting for so long. Ivern versus Kha'Zix, not a matchup we get to talk about, but finally we get a chance.
Well, it actually could still be Lee Sin jungle and Ivern support. It could be Aphromoo having some fun. Otherwise, it could be Lee Sin support. It could be Lee Sin top lane. We don't really know.
I don't mind, man. The Green Daddy's in the house.
Well, the Donger as well. Heimerdinger is making his way into the pick ban. Now I have no idea where anything is going, but if we do see that Ivern in bottom lane, is it a smite support? Do you just steal a camp at level one, get that level two?
Yeah, basically smite is what you take on Ivern regardless of where you go, because you can counter jungle so quickly. So if you know that the guy starts on the top side, go invade, takes you 4 seconds, put that circle down, end up being the friend of the forest, smite it, and boom, take it away.
Yeah, friend of the forest, but not friend of the enemy jungler. I'm wondering what Karsa is going to do here, and the rest of his team. You know, the strategy is getting more and more interesting as we move forward. Oh, but there
Let
it is.
Go.
We were promised the Kalista pick by Reckless. He said, I'm going to ask Mata. I want Masa to pick it. He wanted Kalista Thresh. We see it.
The bot lane just gets insula. Draven and Aphromoo Bard. So it's got to be Lee Sin top lane, I think.
Yeah. They picked an order. They all picked their own champions on the side of Team Fire. But on ice, the Kled comes in, and this is the Praven for Prey. I mean, he got that name, that moniker, because he was really bad at Draven back in the day.
We'll have to see if anything's changed here on the All-Star stage. And not going to quite have the traditional backup that an AD carry expects. Of course, Bard going to be a nice pick, but Heimerdinger, maybe just something he's not so used to playing with. Now, Mata really taking his time. Remember, Reckless asked for Thresh. I don't know if Mata's going to oblige him. Flashing the Yasuo, flashing the Syndra. Clearly still got the 1v1s on his mind.
Yeah, I don't think he should. I mean, you don't want to get too serious when you have the Heimerdinger on the other team. A lot of fun picks. I'm hoping for something a little bit wacky. I would like the Syndra support. I have actually seen this played where you actually ult first, then you do your stun, you max stun. You can do this massive AoE scatter of the week.
I think that's locked.
It's locked.
Oh,
yeah,
there
great.
It is. Okay, but could it go mid lane? Do we have a Katarina? No, this is just Mata.
I don't think so,
Mata at its finest.
And you can see Reckless's face is actually priceless right now. He's not so sure how funny this is. He's like, ooh, I'm unconvinced.
I was really excited about the threat.
I love the contrast here.
Yeah.
Prey was having a good time. It's like, yep.
Well, I mean, one of the beautiful parts about being a play-by-play caster in this situation is that I don't have to wonder what's going to happen. I can ask you gentlemen to tell me, what is this and what is going to happen?
No one knows. Let's be honest here. This is going to be a bit of mayhem.
I predict some fun. That's all I can. That's all I can do. I'm useless right now.
We'll find out. Of course, we're getting ready to move into the game. Kha'Zix in the jungle. We have a Kled in the top lane. Katarina versus Heimerdinger in the mid lane. Lee Sin top two, man.
The best thing about this is you have Lee Sin and Tree Sin on the same team. So you have so many gap closers for your guys. That's going to be so much fun.
I don't know what to say. I'm really excited about Ivern, but there's so many fresh picks here. It's just impossible for me to say anything about what's going to happen. I want to see some team fights. I want to see some people murdering each other. Of course, take this opportunity as we get into game. Hashtag Firewind if you believe the Donger, Ivern, Bard, and the rest of the friends can get together. Or if you believe that Mata and his infamous 1v1 Syndra support can come out on top, tweet out with the hashtag Icewind. Or Clatter Katarina. I mean, really any of these champions you should probably be excited for.
Yeah, I think it's actually going to be really interesting. And I don't know if we're actually going to see Barons and stuff, but both the teams actually can kill Baron pretty well. Heimerdinger actually takes objectives like that super, super fast, and you can set your turrets up around that, plus the all turret. You have Daisy to tank, and obviously on the other side too, we have Kha'Zix, who has the isolation on objectives, and we're going to have Calista too.
And I absolutely love the fact that Ivern, he can hide the dragon, and he can hide the Baron in the brush. So they could actually do a sneaky Baron where they literally have everybody hidden in brush.
Kind of gives it away when everyone's pissing off that. Like, oh, there's a bush here. I wonder.
Maybe. We don't know, man. We don't know how people are going to play around this champion.
Bush it when you walk by and don't actually do it. So then when they walk by, they're like, wait a second. And they walk in.
Oh, not going to get the point here. No gold advantage yet over to Team Fire. But of course, Team Fire playing for some regional pride here. Already doing well so far. Looking to go up 2-0 in these matches.
What they're trying to do is they're trying to figure out where Ivern is starting, and Ivern's trying to figure out where Karse is going to start, so that he can counter jungle and get the other side.
And it's actually pretty important to be able to try to do that. If you can 3-buff on the Ivern, it does give you a really good start, a really good head start, especially because you can pass over the buffs as well. Some of your laners can collect them.
It does look like Ice is laying in wait here. And you can also see that Maple is waiting for an invade on the top side, or I guess the middle of the blue side. And yeah, they're actually just going to trade here. It'll be interesting.
I actually love some of the chat that's happening right now.
Yeah.
So as Maple says, I zero time play against your champ. He's talking to Bjergsen. He's like, I've never played against the Heimerdinger before. So even he doesn't know what's about to happen.
Pretty fantastic. In most competitive games, of course, players completely silent. But here, taking the chance to talk to each other. Bangi starting off procking the passive on the camp there. Moving on to the red buff. Pretty sure to smite that one out is hard.
Oh, no.
To take blue buff, but it does reset there. That's a little unfortunate.
Yeah, it's a lot unfortunate, actually.
Yep.
As we're going to see Bengi just go over and take his blue immediately. So at least for Karsa, he did start his opponent's buff and should be able to kind of go even there.
Quick use of the blast plant to make it over the wall. Friend of the Forest can smite immediately to take that one away. You haven't played against this champion again.
Oh.
It's very frustrating.
And now that they're pushing up on the bottom side, level 2 gank, Ivern come in. You have Root Caller, you have Trigger Seed.
Prey's still level
Let's
one.
Go.
Let's see what happens here. Aphromoo's going to look for the binding.
Find it.
Oh,
he goes in. That's the slow. Mata caught out.
It's still has his binding.
Down. Lots of autos going in. Reckless still putting out a decent amount of damage. Mata, no spells. First blood for the Ivern.
Oh, he put the Trigger Seed on himself. He flashes 70% slow for 3 seconds at level 1 on patch 623. Insane. He didn't even land his Q. He didn't have to use it for so long. And then when he did, he actually missed it and hit it on a creep.
Don't even need to hit it, man. The slow from Trigger Seed, overwhelming there, and Maple holding on, now doing his best to keep up in the mid lane, but Bjergsen unconcerned. He's playing a little PvE.
That's a really good start for Fire, because all 4 summoners are down now, and here we have it once again, so he flashes in, gets the slow on both, and just starts punching him, giving him the beat down here.
Yep.
Does eventually get that first blood.
Knight comes out as well, Mata maybe hoping to get a return kill onto Prey, but no such luck. Mouse and QTV playing. An interesting top lane matchup here. Looks to be going pretty well in favor of Mouse thus far.
And Clyde is a pretty interesting champion. It's a champion a lot of people were expecting to see, you know, in Worlds and in serious competitive play. We saw it once. I believe it was Odo Omni played it one game. Or no, it was actually Splice played it one game.
Wonder.
Wonder did play it, and it didn't go well, and then we never got to see it again.
Yeah, it was played a ton in scrims, but the big thing about it is, hold on.
Oh, bound into the wall. Praven's coming out. It's doing good damage. Ignite goes down. Mata sets
the
ball. It's not a whole lot left. But is Red going to be able to get one back? It comes out. Lots of spears.
Oh.
And Red, not enough. At the end of the day, though, Bangi may be the one who's in trouble. Does manage to land the Root Caller. Maple going to make it in. Nice kill pickup for the mid laner there. And it's just action across the map.
Ugh. No flash available for Bangi either. Had to use it there to get the Trigger Seed in the bottom lane. So went for a really greedy invade.
Yeah, that's pretty aggressive. It doesn't work out from there, but he's still got first blood.
Word.
And he gets a quick trip back to base.
Ooh. Exactly. Faster. QTV now struggling in these trades, but we have see now the Moby boots picked up for Bangi, so it doesn't look like he's going to stop invading the jungle anytime soon. And Portal going to take Fire out there. They're going to spot the control ward, and we'll stick around to take it down.
Yeah, TP from Maple was coming through. And, oh, Karsa!
Oh, no, Karsa, he just wants to shut him down. He's a friend of the forest, Karsa. You can't do this. Oh, nice. Oh. Smite on the camp.
Gets it. He's going out.
The worst part is the Ivern walk is so obnoxious. It's the trying swag. To chase him down.
The swag walk.
It's just overwhelmingly stylish.
The champion gets so frustrating to play against as he gets stronger and stronger. Like once he has redemption, once he has his locket and he's building up these really kind of tanky items, he still actually has a good amount of damage and dueling power with the Daisy. And he's just running around spamming shields with high CDR, with the Athenes, with builds like that. You can hit the 45% CDR and basically have full uptime on your ult.
Yeah, the thing though is he went for the mobility boots here instead of the Ionian boots and Lucidity. And ooh. Oh, Mouse missed the EQ.
Karsa goes in, he's gonna leave. This should be an easy pickup. Thunderlord's procs, Pocket Pistol comes out, and Karsa gonna take that one away.
Yep.
Gotta say, you know, Bangi making some good early moves on this Ivern, but Karsa's keeping up so far.
Yeah, and it's an aggressive jungler as well. A lot of people were saying, well, can Ivern actually hold up against aggressive junglers? He can, but the aggressive jungler, if it's a really good player, could punish him super hard because he's usually pretty low during those early parts. Bengi got super greedy with a topside invade and used his flash. So Karsa knows that he can walk into the jungle and be perfectly fine against whatever Bengi's going to do. Bengi doesn't have the damage to kill him.
Bjergsen not looking perfectly fine in the mid lane as they continue forward, but...
Oh, triple man. Aphromoo is also here with the Bard Portal.
Win. Three people in the mid lane. Trickster's going to go down. 70% slow. Flash out. Bluecaller not going to connect. And I think what Fire's learned from watching Maple play Katarina last time is that maybe you just don't want to let him have a free lane. Maybe you don't want the Katarina to get comfortably to that mid-game stage.
Hey, certainly don't. And the double buffs gifted over to him from Bengi earlier were not really helping Bjergsen out in that lane. Even just the HP regen plus the Negatron cloak does afford you a pretty easy lane. But Bjergsen has been doing very well for himself. And in comes the Glade ult.
Charge. Bjergsen's in trouble. Could get locked up here. Exhaust goes down onto the Katarina. Bjergsen bear trap on a pole. Joust through. Mouse takes him down. Skarl going to make his way out, but QTV's on his way in. Now pulling back as Reckless gets aggressive. A little bit too much, so but Prey is stunned up. Ignite goes down. Heal not going to be enough to take him. Is going to get one. Will he look for two? I don't think so. Yes. Not going to find it in the end, but Banky's now the one in trouble. Non-stop action reset on it. He can't get it one more time. Maple makes it out.
Oh, the triple E to get there. Picks them all up. And QTV, though, might actually have him here. He's going to try to back.
Maple. Get some resets on the dagger.
He's going to get the XQ.
Oh. Yeah, Bjergsen was walking up towards that way, and then he decided to just change route and go towards the mid lane.
There was such good timing on that dive on Bjergsen because he was a few creeps away from six. He actually hit six right as he died. And as you can see, this dive happening, they're flying in, and Bjergsen doesn't have the ultimate to actually retaliate very much here. So as he gets away, just hit six, but it's obviously way too late there. Just a couple seconds off of being able to have that ultimate and perhaps turn that fight around.
Of course, good communication coming in from the side of Team Ice. We have to consider the language barriers here, but of course, Mouse, Karsa, and Maple, all Mandarin speakers, so relatively easy to communicate those more complicated gank timings. Not quite the same state of affairs for old Bangi and Bjergsen.
I mean, one thing that the players do get pretty used to, though, playing a lot of ranked play, is just communicating with pings, right? You can smart ping your abilities now, you can smart ping when you're coming, when you're gonna gank, you can target people, and that does really communicate a lot of what you need.
I will say, whenever I watch like an LPL game that has a mixed language team, it is so easy as a caster to know exactly what the team wants to do. It's like, oh, I think they want to do Baron next. It's like five on my way pings, five help me pings on the dragon every single time.
Yeah, I'm questioning where you learned all this ping communication. I just get the question mark ping in solo queue. That's the only one I ever get, good
five
or bad.
Yeah.
They're really curious as to why my corpse is on the ground most of the time. I don't quite understand what they're looking for.
Yeah, the pings don't help. They really don't. Just actually makes it happen more often to my experience. I get tilted off that.
Well, of course, no one's getting tilted here. Prey's having an okay laning phase. We'll move forward. 0-1 and 2, but Reckless building up a pretty decent CS lead. And surprisingly, the central support working out. Seen it once or twice in competitive, as you mentioned earlier, using the ult to set up those stuns.
Definitely not a common pick, though, and not really a lane that you would expect them to be winning, especially when they got first blooded and then immediately died again, and all that kind of advantage was given over to Prey and Aphromoo.
Yep, it's the Praven in full effect. They just couldn't deal with Reckless there. And also, like, there's a red buff actually sitting here because Bengi picked it up. You can pick it up as a teammate, and nobody's come to pick it up yet. So, Bjergsen, is that yours? Waddle on over here.
A lot of movement around. Well, Karsa sort of waiting in the wings here.
Up.
No one wants to take on the Kha'Zix quite yet. Maple, of course, here as well. Bot lane potentially in trouble.
Yeah, they have to back up here. Now Bengi's going to be over on this side.
Double blast cone.
Oh, this is going to be bad for them. We'll see if they can get out.
Locked up, Ray trying to kill the wave with the ultimate there. Does get
Let's go, Daisy.
He wants to go, but Daisy is on the way in. Tempered Fate connects onto two. He's going to stop that action in its tracks. And ain't nobody trying to fight Daisy.
You see Daisy, everybody has to run away.
Yeah, the icon's going to get flashed there as Aphromoo. And Prey will survive, and Bjergsen was able to push mid lane, so he is winning on farm, obviously down on gold because Maple has been able to pick up these kills, and it just seems every time this guy gets an assassin, he's doing so, so well on it. Really is showing off a champion that, while it's kind of a fun pick now because it's new, I think it is going to become very standard and competitive, as it seems like it's just straight up good.
Yeah. Completely agree with you. Kha'Zix and Katarina both quite good champions.
The dream scenario we talked about, gentlemen. There are three members hiding in that bush.
Daisy, come back!
Control Ward will spot them out. Daisy's gonna drop. Reckless. Monster. Now maybe looking to take the dragon. Of course, haven't seen Kha'Zix in a long time, but is good at controlling these objectives.
Oh. Rent it away.
Wall not gonna get it. Maple's 101 though. Maybe biting off more than he can chew. Starts to spin to win. That's gonna be enough. Wants to jump in. Prey could be next on the menu. They want more. The resets are coming in. Mouse out of nowhere. Gonna grab the double kill. Beautiful play from Team Ice.
Mouse with the teleport and the charge to get in there. And no answer possible from QTV. Ice, and they end up going really far ahead off that play. And they get the Drake to boot.
Yeah, they get the dragon, they get all the kills, they're going to get the first turret here as well. QTV pushing up in top lane, but things are looking pretty rough for Fire.
Been a rough road so far already. I mean, we can hope for the Ivern, the Heimerdinger, maybe if they fight somewhere on their terms. I mean, what is the next step here for this team?
Learn your champion a little bit better throughout the course of the game. Oh, pick up what the Heimerdinger does, pick up what all these guys do, play around it a little bit better. Like, right here, like, they don't have QTV. QTV isn't really keeping track of the Kled either. He does have kick, and he sees that Kled just runs all the way away.
Yeah. Yep. There's the TP coming in now. So you can notice Maple can go in. He goes aggressive here. He's able to get so much damage in. And then there's Mouse with the ultimate. Takes down one, takes down two. He's able to do it so quickly there and really showing off the power of the Kled. The initiation from him with that ultimate is so powerful, and once you start triggering the resets for Maple, he's massive.
Oh, Kars is going in though, and he's already looking massive. Bangy's in trouble, tries to get some friends in the forest. Just gives him barely enough life to make it out. Now Karsa has to run. Oh, moving forward, he does go down, but now the bear trap on a rope is gonna do a decent amount of damage. Maple left all alone.
Oh, Bangy with it!
Go in, no, don't go in, just make Daisy go. Maple now caught out all alone. Maybe we'll get another kill. Can't get the dagger to reset the E. Not gonna
Oh, he ran back
yet.
Into the turret.
Tower. Oh, Draven, not gonna get it. The fancy footwork shut down for Aphromoo. Maple living forever.
Oh, that was hilarious. That Bjergsen dropped the ultimate turret there. They ran away from it, and then Maple jumped to a dagger over beside him. He's like, whoops! He took a couple shots. Does end up going down.
And Bengi takes his cue as well to go back in when he seemed to be fine there.
Sometimes you get eager. Sometimes you want Daisy to do the thing, and then you do the thing.
You land the Q.
You accidentally die to the Katarina.
Mine's telling you no.
Biggie preparing for next season, learning Ivern as he goes. Some of the nuances there, some not quite. But Prey now getting aggressed onto by Reckless. But Mata now going to get alley-ooped into the team fight. Flashes over the wall just to secure it, and they're going to get the kill in the end. But Bangy caught between a rock and a hard place. Really nothing left for him. Now running through control ward. Heal does come out.
Nice ulti from Afro.
JCC is there, does land it. That's two. Maple now moving in, though. He wants to pick up the rest of the kills. Bjergsen's going to say no. Blast cone
for the disengage.
Yeah, and here comes the Kled ulti. There you can hear it.
Oh,
for Bjergsen.
No. Oh, Bjergsen flashed him under the tower. Maybe this is a fight that Bjergsen wants, but he does so much damage. Kar'Sa now moving in, not going to get the reset. Only level 6, or only level 8, rather. Now Maple trying to make his way out. The kick does connect. Lee Sin finally going to grab one, putting some numbers on the board for QTV.
Maple is just tearing through people on this Kled. He has the Black Cleaver already completed and chops down Bjergsen, getting his summoners too.
And Mouse is having the game of his turn so far. And Aphromoo!
Make his way out. Kar'Sa hungry for blood. The control ward will spot him, but Prey is here. Maybe at least for a little bit of disengage.
He's picking on someone his own size, the pink ward.
Having to back off. It's a rough road here for Team Ice. These are a lot of
Ooh,
terrifying 0
for 2 chances. There from Reckless. He failed the blast cone, failed his Q over the wall.
It seems pretty awkward with Kalista, though. He just stopped. You have to accept, I'm not going to jump this time. I'm just going to auto attack.
Oh, QTV, they're closing in on him. Mata is here.
I haven't kind of touched on the Syndra support, but it seems to be doing very well. Mata, hungry for blood this game. We saw in the last play, flashing over the wall just to get the Fates call. Try to secure that kill in the mid lane.
I mean, like, Reckless himself just this entire tournament has been playing out of his mind. Really going hard in all these game modes.
Darsa, though, it is Mouse on top of it.
Finish up the rope, knock.
Oh, the turnaround!
Gonna get taunt! Oh, that's so much damage! Draven can now afford to get aggressive, but is just gonna back off. Nice play coming to Prey and Aphramu.
Yeah, finally gets a cash in, too. Prey had died multiple times there before picking up anything.
Of course, now they're starting to push in. Mouse gonna have to be careful, but he's got backup on the way. Bottom lane coming in, the Mata. Ooh, Mouse is gonna get aggressive. Will get dismounted here. Does have the pocket pistol. He's gonna grab one.
Oh, there he goes.
Ooh, little Kled all on his own. Pistol shot, the fade away, the double kill. Mouse 6-0-1.
Mouse is doing his best Graves impression there. The buckshot taking down Aphramu, and he is just going off. It has to feel so good with the amount of flack this guy gets all the time.
Yeah, and I mean, he was voted in, and people were like, what happened? Like, the guy had to leave Worlds a little bit early because of personal reasons, and they were like, okay, let's get it. He's having a great time here, and that's awesome to see. And this Kled, man, once you get ahead, it just snowballs so hard. And I hear it again. It's up at the top lane. He's going to go for a charge.
Moving forward, Bjergsen's the one who's in trouble, though, and now he is going to get stunned up. Maple just taking his time on this sweet kill. He is going to grab it in the end, but the tower to make his life a little bit harder. Still going to grab that one in the end.
All those daggers. Once you learn the pattern to picking them up and using the Shumpo 3-4 times in a row, it gets pretty insane. But hold on, he's gonna need more.
Over here comes QTV, kicks Mata back into the tower. Fades call! Daisy's here to play though. QTV,
Karts is behind him.
You gotta respect the golem, but he gets cut through so quickly. No one gonna drop on the side of Team Ice, but Team Fire are dropping members left and right.
Yeah, these guys are just playing it so well and looking so good on some of these champions. The Kled has been massive. Reckless has been tearing it up on the Kalista, one of his signature champions. And now Maple with the Rylai's completed. There's almost no escaping him.
We check in on the gold, almost 6K in the favor of Team Ice as well as that Moundrake. They're just getting farther and farther ahead. You can see some of the differences between these lanes. The Katarina, 1,500 just about ahead of Bjergsen. It's pretty terrifying to play against.
Looking for the Infernal here. TP from behind. You can see it on the minimap, but that means that they know on Team Fire side. Oh, they're surrounded here. They have to get out.
Fancy footwork, the fog of war, the horror movie stream. Where are the bad guys going to come from? Team Fire doesn't know.
It's from all over.
Oh, trying to take the portal to safety. It is going to be a magical journey because they're caught behind enemy lines, and no one except Bangi made it anywhere he wanted to be.
The important thing to remember situations like this, you don't have to run faster than the other team. You just have to run faster than one of your team.
Oh, Bangi, the slowest man left not standing as Team Fire going to look for the desperate recall here.
Oh, they're in enemy territory.
It's a relentless pursuit.
Oh, Mata's gonna check it. He's gonna throw a Q.
Oh, doesn't E? It doesn't use the. Prey! Oh no!
Aphramu made it back!
Aphramu, the lone survivor. The fastest runner on the team, side of Team Fire.
I mean, to be honest, Prey started that recall pretty slow. Aphro was a good second or two faster. Otherwise, they could have been out of there scot free.
Yeah, that's when you're like, are we turning? Are we fighting? What are we doing?
This is the future of the new meta. Rift Tail. We saw it taken last game. We'll see it taken again after not seeing any competitive play for the majority of the season.
Yeah, when you have a 7-0-1 Kled, you definitely pick that thing up. It'll be on until, what, 28 minutes into the game? Oh, hello!
UTV, that's not what he wanted. Oh, air trap on a pole doesn't connect. That's a decent amount of damage.
Yeah, 38 minutes.
20-minute timer, of course. It's a pretty impressive time period. Ooh, Aphramu, nice stun over the wall, but making a lot of escape potential here. Is not going to get stunned up. Bangi goes forward. The ultimate channel turret still doing damage. Daisy is on the hunt. Maple doesn't care, but he should because the tower's going to take him down. Prey popping off on the backside.
Bjergsen going to pick up his first kill of the game, so finally getting involved there as Maple and Karsa bite off more than they can chew, and we'll see if Fire can get something back and pick up this Infernal.
They're going to go after the Infernal, but Mouse has his ultimate. He has charge.
See him waiting on the top side. Looks like he's just taking the Scuttlecrab. May just continue to push. He can just make his way down. He has a massive range on the ultimate, but instead.
He's out. Yeah, trying to figure out if he wanted to do it or not. But he doesn't. Unlucky.
Team Fire thematically getting the Fire Drake. Feels appropriate. Of course, Ana Vecna's gonna have to be careful not.
Whoa, he got him just on the very edge.
The stun coming in. Doesn't matter if you flash, buddy. The bar Q's still gonna connect.
The Prey?
It up, but they should have tried to save Prey because he is the one burning down. Reckless looking for the chance. Not gonna get it. He gets taken out in the end. And Maple caught on the backside. But here comes the charge from the Kled. Not gonna connect. He flashes into the action. Lee Sin's already got a double kill. Aphromoo is now set to fall, but Bangy's doing his best to save. No, portal out. There's simply too many escapes. There's nothing left. Maple trying to make the hero play, but I don't think he has enough damage.
Bjergsen's
with the dagger
looking
in the backside. The rockets go in, but Bjergsen, I find too much there. Mouse getting a kill.
Oh, the ulti, the rocket ulti from Bjergsen got immune by the dismount animation from Mouse as he's hopping off. You can't hit him.
It over the wall. Maple's on
Maple's the wall.
The reset from Maple. He wants more. He's not going to get Bjergsen. The rocket's going to take him down.
That's what I call playing like a man. Maple is not backing down, embracing the all-star spirit. You got to love it.
You got to go big or you got to go home. It's the last match he's going to be playing here. Oh, man. That was like, it looked like it was going to be Fire's moment there, but Ice, they turned it around and they almost make it an even trade, though.
This has to be the most irritating team to fight in the history of teams.
It looked like it was going to be a 3-0. The fact that they try to get Prey here, it's like, all right, let's get Prey. It's like, oh, he's got all these spears in him, can't rend it. Oh, he gets a shield, walk away. Oh, here comes the Kled from the backside. He just walks forward, flashes to the left afterwards, can't get in on him. Karsten has jumped too.
Watch Maple, look at him. QTV is trying to chase him down here on the back end of this fight. And it looks like he's for sure dead, but he's so slippery on the Katarina. He's able to jump back to his dagger, then back to a minion. That has to be so frustrating watching him get away.
You gotta think of these team fights. It just has to be overwhelming to play against this many kind of oddball champions. You've got turrets being set up. You've got Daisy trying to auto attack you to death. You've got Brush popping up in the middle of the fight. A Katarina with seemingly limitless escapes. Mouse, though,
don't run away.
So lucky.
Run right at him.
This is the man mode. This is what Zayo wanted to see. He does get it in the end.
Really good by Maple as well. He threw the Q, and the Q will always bounce about 300 units behind the first person you hit. So just flies over the wall, gets an E, so he gets a reset on that Shumpo for the kill.
Ice now moving into the bottom side. We'll have to see if Maple can get more resets. He's taking his time in the mid lane, though, to push up. The rest of the team pretty preoccupied with that bot tier, too.
Yeah, QTV is up in the top lane still, and
does have his TP, but there's not really any good wards here.
And
in comes the Kled charge.
And Mouse doing a decent amount of damage, but Aphromoo looking for the disengage. Mouse, the lone man into the tower. It doesn't matter. He takes down Prey. A lot of knockups going in. Karsa looking for another kill. Aphromoo barely makes it out. Bangy has to play safe here. Rootcaller not going to connect.
QTV still split pushing. He canceled that TP and is going to be pushing into this turret, but I think Ice is just going to try to force the inhibitor turret, and I think they're going to get it.
Yeah.
Forward, Reckless doing decent damage. Karsa as well. Maple even has enough AP to start hitting hard here.
Yeah, and you can see Mouse on the top side. He's going to continue to push and try to get up there and try to stop QTV.
Maple caught up. Is just going to snap back to his teammates, trying to make it to safety. Mouse looking for the joust. Not going to find it.
Oh, QTV had used a teleport too and canceled it. So yeah, Mouse has the TP advantage. This just looks pretty bad for a Fire right now. A lot of advantages.
I like the play coming in from Mata. He says, I know how to counter this Ivern. I'm just going to pick up this Golem and take it away from you. No Daisy, no problem.
We have a conversation about that earlier today, if it happened or not. Obviously, you can.
And here's the dive one more time. Mouse, not afraid at all. Takes down Prey right away. And someone has to soak that ultimate. You need to be the closest person to it. So your AD carry is not and doesn't die at the very start of the fight.
And Mouse, of course, almost going down in a 1v1 against the Heimerdinger empowered tower there. Or powered turret, rather.
Tower defense, League of Legends style.
Another Q.
Oh, Maple hungry for more. Ooh, exhausted. Ooh. The Lee Sin kick. Just carries it right into his teammate there in QTV, making the hero play to save Bjergsen.
Oh, Baron pings onto Baron here. They do have a Kalista on the side of Team Ice. So Reckless, be able to do a lot there.
Bangy, is he going to burn a smite here? Does have the camp stacked up, doesn't need to. Have to be careful. Reckless very low.
Yeah, Bjergsen's in base, so they're going to have to wait for him. And here comes the Kled once again.
QTV makes it over the wall, but there's just more members waiting for him. Too many jumps, too much mobility. Ice picking up one before they start this Baron.
And that's going to be tough. They can just keep baiting here. And if Fire is not going to come check, they'll start it up. And that's exactly what they're going to do. They have the Kalista. Has been spotted out by the blue trinket, though.
Isolated damage from the Kha'Zix, the Kalista Spears stacking up with Vangie, trying to make his play in. Daisy gets kidnapped, and now the Fates Call comes in. Bjergsen gets caught out. Daisy finally into the team, but Maple's in the back line. Gets one, looking to get two. Karsa making the bounce house happen as the duo just cuts through the team.
The double resets, tag teaming down Fire, taking out one after another. These guys are just jumping everywhere.
It's so much mobility, and the fact that they're going to pick up a Baron afterwards as well, it's going to be more than a 10k gold lead here, and Ice are just looking on fire.
And most of the time when we cast games like this, there's one champion with resets that we need to watch in a fight, but now there's a Kha'Zix and a Katarina. I can't even keep up anymore. But Aphromoo,
finally,
a little bit of time.
Didn't like that one bit.
Maple, oh, yeah, gets him. Clean Katarina play coming in. Aphromoo runs for his life, but the dagger is still going to land, hit its mark.
Certainly will. It feels like it's hard to miss when point and click, but they are getting another Baron, and they're getting themselves so far ahead. And Bjergsen just can't stay alive in these fights, even with some peel from his team, even with the shields from that Ivern. He's going to go down so quickly, and then the resets start coming in. Once one dies, the rest are pretty much sure to follow.
Oh, yeah, and they don't really have any tanks on the side of Fire. Ice, the Kled's going to be able to just rip through anybody. Karsa will get those squishies. And Bengi, he's not hiding the Drake. It's not in a bush.
Oh, Stealth comes up. Charges on the way in, too. Looks like they want a party.
Oh, Prey
is going to be the first target. That's the reset we talked about. Maple's on the back line. Keep your eyes on the blast cone. One going to go down. The double kill for Karsa. Maybe hunger for more blood gonna come out here.
Yeah, Maple's here.
Oh,
they definitely
Maple
want
wants it. One dagger for reset. He can get two into the back line. Backer move. Nice disengage on the Bard.
Oh, poor Prey, man. Poor Prey. Every single time. There's nobody to soak it for him. There's no frontliners. He gets the Kled ulti almost every time.
Yeah, Prey's not having a good time against all these assassins, all this dive. And here comes a TP right back from Maple, and they're looking to try to finish this game.
Oh, Mouth goes in, and no one's doing any damage. This character is simply too tanky, not getting opportunities to turn back. Karsa wants a little bit more. Dagger does land. Maple goes for it. He's going to jump in, spin to win, trying to get a little bit more.
Ooh, oh, he wanted
not quite
it.
Enough. Prey does manage to take him down to the end. Karsa!
Karsa was just the BM Rico.
Oh, Fate's Call goes in and it's Bangy's fate to fall down. Prey, unfortunately, next on the menu, gets a brief glimmer of hope as he takes down the Katarina and immediately falls. Team Ice cleaning up house.
They take down the Katarina and they're gonna take down the game. The ace for Team Ice as they're gonna snuff out Fire.
1-1 now in these last three matches as we approach our final mixed team match. Team Ice, it's crazy picks and an even crazier win, but they're going to close it out with confidence. A beautiful set of fights and an absolutely insane game. Or they're not going to hit. Please hit the Nexus.
Don't make it one more time.
Oh, one more. All right. Mana needed the stat pad. Beautiful win at the end of the day.
Taking one for the road there.
That was a fun one. Mouse just put on absolute clinic on the Kled. 11-0-10. On Kled, and definitely getting some help there from Maple. It was 10-6-7, but really it was Mouse doing most of the heavy lifting, and this guy was everywhere.
He shows up in the mid lane, kills Bjergsen on what was an excellently coordinated dive, and then just starts charging into every team fight. Every time we think, oh yeah, oh they're gonna make it out, Fire's good, they're gonna make it out. Suddenly there's a Kled in the back line, charging through.
Yeah. I mean, right off the start, he wins his lane, he ultimate, kills Bjergsen, TP's bot, kills them. He wins all three lanes essentially for his team. That is a fantastic game.
Yeah, it looks like a good suit there for Mouse. Maybe we'll see it from him in the future. Who knows? Because this champion, I mean, it got a couple of kind of changes / buffs and one nerf, but Kled's looking pretty strong. Who knows?
I can't say I fully understand Kled after that game, but an insane champion to watch. It's so much fun to cast as well. Bear Trap on a Rope is my favorite ability name to say, so always happy to see Kled.
Yeah, definitely a really, really fun one. And I think the best part about a lot of these champions is that we're going to continue to get to see Katarina, I think. And I'm really hoping that we are going to see some Kalista coming back with, you know, Blade of the Rune King getting buffed. It seems like people are more willing to play the champion again. And, you know, we saw that champion as a mainstay for so long, and then we haven't for such a long time now. It's really fun to see it come back into the meta.
Yeah, saw a little bit of play as I Am Oakland as well, being busted out by Veritas, a surprising pick. We didn't expect it to do well. It went off here today. It's been doing well in 1v1s as well, so a really fun champion to watch. Always the Fate's Call makes it so exciting, and additionally, a lot of kind of crazy picks here. Kha'Zix one of the ones as well that I didn't really expect to see, but now the teams have a little bit more liberty to experiment. really exciting to watch.
Yeah, absolutely. And the Kalista, you know, a lot of people are saying it's incredibly weak right now. It's incredibly hard to play. May not feel that great, but apparently a lot of these pros still think it's a great champion to gravitate towards. And when you want to have your support, make some plays. Even though Mata's not a Syndra, it's still a good champion to pick up.
And to be fair, Mata did pick a playmaking support of his own. a little more damage than, I think, traditional support position there. But
got a sidestone, though. You got a sidestone.
That's, remember, folks, that's the difference.
I was very proud of him. I didn't think there was any chance you were going to see a sidestone. So I was like, oh, yeah, good job. Like, you're supporting.
Yeah, we don't want to set a bad example for solo queue here. If you're support, please buy a sidestone.
Yeah, right. Even if you want to play Syndra support and your team doesn't want you to play Syndra support, still buy a sidestone.
Should be good in the end. Of course, just waiting for a moment for the analyst desk to get set up and ready. But in the meantime, I mean, really looking at those last few plays was just an absolutely insane game. But Mouse feels like the clear MVP.
I agree. I think that Mouse, no deaths in a game mode like this where everybody else has like 4, 5, 6. We have somebody with 9 with Prey. Poor guy. But the fact that he was able to just take over the top lane, it is a favorable matchup for him. But he got some help from Karsa. Like, this guy is snowballed. This was Mouse's day. This was Mouse's game.
Absolutely. But of course, for more on that game, let's send it over to the analyst desk for Shox and Crew to break that one down.
Thank you, Daniel Dracos. We were ready, actually, but then Kobe found out his hair wasn't good and we had to fix it for
guys. What?
We need that for
Don't make me
game.
Mad, Sean.
All right. Well, Kobe has joined us as well as. Oh, sorry.
Whoa.
As well as Papa Mithy.
Yeah, what do we do up here on the analyst desk after games like that?
We analyze them, obviously, and we're going to take a look at the picks and bans like you've never done that before. I thought one thing was really funny. We had Reckless up here before, and he said, I'm so excited to play with Mata, and, you know, we talked about we're going to be taking it serious, and we're going to see what we can do. Mata does whatever the hell he damn well pleases in this tournament. He played Syndra support. Break it down, Mithy.
What is there to say? I've never seen it before.
Know. I have seen it before. We had some of this in Korea. Now, the mechanic here is that you ult first, then E, and you actually get multi-man stuns because you have all the extra spheres on the battle ground.
Take notes, silly.
It's still around, Mithy.
Give me the pen, give me the pen.
The book's closed. The book should still be closed because there's a lot of silly stuff in this game. The elephant in the room, though, wasn't the Heimerdinger. It was Prey on Draven again. Draven is a thing. It should never be a thing. He doesn't win on this champion. He was awful.
I was going to attack the Heimerdinger. You say
you
that?
Would. You
say
would.
That's not a story, but man, he's so squishy. And I don't, you know, profess to be a Donger expert, but I'm pretty sure you build a Zonya on him to try and at least stay alive to let the turrets do some damage. But man, he was just annihilated it very quickly.
I know you guys are afraid of attacking the three-time world champion. Yeah, sorry. But but I felt a bit like Bengi was inting it a little bit. After he did a good thing going bot and getting that kill, but after that he gave double buffs to Katarina and it just like went downhill from there. I think it was like 1-9 or something in the end.
Yeah. I mean, all jokes aside, you could tell that he was not really practiced on the champion. There were a couple times, you know, the snare from Ivern, if you click on him afterwards, it takes you into that champion.
You wouldn't know that from the game.
He had a couple really good, you know, high-value snares on these dangerous champions, but then he'd, like, take the snare in. Oh, I'm dead. Plus, his pathing a little bit with Ivern, if you prep a camp, then there's a lot of money in there, but you have to return. Mm-hmm. He would leave those, then get those counter-jungled, so that's, like, losing double time because you already spent the health and mana to prep it.
But
okay, collect. But
he had to follow Mouse around the whole map. Of course, he was putting some insane pressure down. Let's take a look at the Knight of the Living Cled powered by Acer. Mouse was absolutely going off on that champion, not just in the top lane, but literally everywhere.
And it's a pick that we saw, you know, a couple of times. Well, it didn't impress, but you see the champion, see the ultimate, and you're like, this champion has potential. We're waiting for it to hit the competitive realm. And okay, it is a bit of a pseudo competitive game, but Mouse had a day out in this one.
I heard he's actually a decent pick into Poppy, so I'm excited for IEM Korea. I don't exactly know
good
where
try,
it
good
is.
Try. Yeah,
okay. Awesome. Okay. So maybe we see it there. We will never know until then.
We will never know until next week.
That's like a couple of days away, actually, but the next event on the calendar. But I mean, against Poppy, it's going to be very relevant because Poppy's clearly going to be around for a long time. Mm-hmm. So
definitely.
Any picks that work against it.
That's why I was saying maybe we see that, but we'll probably end up seeing everyone tanking it around.
Yeah, maybe we will. I don't think there will be too much repeated. I always think it's funny to look at these and look who sticks to their own role and then who are the guys who are just really there to have fun. So Mata picked Syndra. Lee Sin for QTV, that's still pretty much in it, but everyone else just played in their role. Bjergsen did play Heimerdinger, which is, as you said, it wasn't that successful and probably couldn't be successful in any scenario.
One day.
Whoa. You're ruling out the Heimerdinger success.
No.
There is definitely a way the Heimerdinger can be successful.
For sure, guys. Play as much Heimerdinger as possible in solo.
especially mid.
Yeah. All right. Cool. Well, that's one for ice, one for fire. We'll see what happens next. So we're going to take a quick break. But when we return, we will have our final match of the tournament. Make sure you stick around because we'll be ending this week with a special closing ceremony performance of League of Legends music favorites, including a tease of the upcoming Pentakill 2 album. Don't go anywhere.
What's behind?
The world has changed. The war we're fighting today needs a different kind of soldier.
Get on your knees!
If you wanted me back, you could have just asked me.
Let me simplify it for you. Kick some ass and try to look dope while you're doing it.
I could definitely make that work.